Hi folks, I'm here with my 2007 Chevy Malibu, and I just want to share with you how to change the disc brakes in the front. Now there's a couple of ways people usually handle this. One is to just replace the pads only, because typically the discs or the rotors are in good shape, but sometimes the rotors have problems. They could be warped, they could have scrapes or any number of things. So usually when the rotors go bad, you can either get the rotors resurfaced or you can just replace them. Now in my case, I usually replace the rotors because it's relatively inexpensive, and resurfacing just makes them thinner and more prone to warpage in the future. So that's my approach right now, just replace the whole thing.
So I went online and I found a disc pad and rotor set at a reasonable price. Not the cheapest, but not the most expensive. And they look pretty reasonable. There's the pads, and here's the disc rotor, nicely packed in plastic. So let's go ahead and start tearing down the setup and install these. Here's all the tools I'm going to be using. The most important one that you may not use on a daily basis is the C-clamp, which I use to compress the caliper to get the pads, make a space for the new pads. Pretty much everything else is pretty typical. You know, socket set, tire iron, and there's the jack. So let's get started on this. Always put your emergency brake on before you jack up the car. When you jack up the car, you want to find a good solid point. So I'm going to use this right here, which where they recommend. If you don't want to crush anything underneath your car and cause body damage. I'm going to just get high enough to get the tire off the ground. This also has a little safety stick on it. To make it a little easier to get to the caliper bolts, I'm going to turn this out with the steering wheel. Here's a closer look, and the actual nut I want to remove is this one right here. There's also another one on the bottom, right there. I'm a big fan of using this breaker bar to remove these bolts, because you know, the older you get, the less strength you have, and it helps a lot. This has a half inch, but I have a 3/8 inch set, so I got this adapter which I attach to it. And I have this number 15 socket which fits right over. So let me just get that. It comes right off. The bottom one. Finish the job with a 3/8 inch ratchet. I You never want this thing hanging, so find some way to hold it in place. Maybe a piece of wire or something. I'm gonna hang it here for now. You got the rotor coming right off. Now, one of the reasons I replaced this is because this rotor has some damage here. You can see a ring right here. And it's causing noise, so I'm just gonna get to replace it. In some cases, you had no problem except for the pads wearing out. In other cases, you might have a leaky caliper, in which case you have a whole other problem to deal with, but I don't need to worry about that. You also, on this, it has a sliding mechanism here, and it's smooth. You don't have any issues, so I'm not gonna even worry about that. I'm just going to take out these old pads and I'm going to replace them with the new pads. But in order to replace them with the new pads, I need to push this cylinder down into this to make room for the new pads because they're thicker than the old pads. So that's where my C-clamp comes into play. Now to compress the caliper piston, I'm going to be using this C-clamp. And it's pretty simple. You just stick it through the hole, line it up with it, and just tighten it down. You want to pretty much get this almost flush with the rest of the body. You want to make sure not too much fluid in the reservoir or it'll come out the other end. But I already checked that and it seems to be okay. So it's pretty much bottom out. You don't want it too tight. Just you can feel when it gets too tight it won't turn anymore. It looks to me like it's pretty flush already, so that's good. Now we take it out. Now you notice inside here, there's a rubber seal that goes around this. You want to make sure you don't see any leakage. And you don't want to pinch this rubber seal when you put the new pads on either. So that's important to watch out for when you put the new pads in place. Now when you get your pads, you'll notice that one of them has a little metal tab sticking up. That's always going to go on the inside. And the one without the metal tab goes on the outside. Another trick I've learned over the years is they have this disc brake quiet. I bought this years ago and it's still good, so I use it every time I replace my brakes. And you put this on the back of the pad and it helps reduce squeaking and it just holds it together better. You just want to put some across this. You can put some across this way as well. This one's a little wider because I have a wider surface to touch. They recommend letting this dry for about 10 minutes before you put it on, so I'm going to go ahead and wait 10 minutes for that. Okay, now we've had 10 minutes. Let's go ahead and mount these. You want to be careful not to get any finger oil or any kind of oil on these. They need to stay dry. Just slip right in. There's little clips here to kind of hold it in place. kind of wiggle this back and forth just to work it down so we don't pinch that rubber seal. Now let's just set this out of the way so we can get the rotor on. Put one bolt here just to kind of hold it in place. And then we want to just slip the caliper over that. Attach the bolt. And at this point, you just want to snug down the bolts and then give it a torque. I like to give it about 85 foot-pounds of torque. That's the recommended amount for this bolt. Okay, and now for the torque wrench. Pretty simple to use. You just set the setting by turning this. You can set the setting. I have it set for 85 foot-pounds, and then when you turn this, and tell it, you can get a click. I'm gonna do the top and bottom first. Ah, there you go. There's a click. And there's a click, so that's it. And now we just put the tire on and we're all finished for this side of the car. Just have these snug. I'm just gonna go ahead and drop this just so the tire barely touches the ground. Just get a little more leverage when I tighten the bolts. Now in some cars you could get warpage on the disc, and in this case this car is prone to warpage, so it's a good idea to always torque the wheel nuts to 100 foot-pounds on this car. That makes it less susceptible to a warpage issue. I always do a star pattern in this. And now finally, the wheel cover. This has a cheap plastic wheel cover with plastic nuts. If you're lucky to have a high quality, you don't need to worry about this. But for me, with the cheap plastic nuts, you don't want to tighten too much because you'll strip the threads. So just do these just barely finger tight. And that completes the right side. I'm going to do the same thing on the left. one final thing. Once you got your new brakes installed, you're going to want to pump up the brakes a little bit. Just slowly pump it up and down with the engine running, just to make sure that the fluid fills up all the calipers. You don't want to push all the way down. Just push like halfway and just keep pumping it until you get a firm pedal, and then you should be ready to go.